corporate media, Fox Sports people, CNN, MSNBC, why so many of them all say the same thing is because someone like Tim Burke knows everything about them. He's hacked into their lives. He's got them by the balls.
Back 10 years ago, Deadspin was still a very relevant website. For the most part, they were still who they wanted to be. And they uncovered that the mainstream media was very lazy in crafting a very safe, Disney-like narrative. And again, maybe we've all been guilty of it as media members of going for the easy route. But man, they were a part of this story. I don't know if they were intentionally complicit, but Jesus, they did not do their job, Jason, in their due diligence.
That was certainly pointed out. I can't be that harsh a judge of it because guy says his girlfriend dies. My instincts aren't to go, well, let me check that story out. Did his girlfriend actually die? Yeah, that wouldn't be my instincts. Who lies about something like that? And so it's a good look for Deadspin. Hats off to them. They broke that story. It's one of the best pieces of journalism that they did. But I'm not sure if everybody else looks as horrible as they would like for ESPN or the New York Times and, again, Sports Illustrated. Look, I'm a critic of all those places, but I'm not sure if I would have sniffed out this story as much as Deadspin did. Here, my takeaway as it related to Deadspin was Timothy Burke, who ended up becoming one of the editors of Deadspin and someone I can't personally stand. A low character individual, and this documentary, you know, paints him as, you know, some sort of great journalist. But I had a different takeaway. I don't know if any of this crossed your mind, but it's like they showed this shack that Timothy Burke is living in down in Florida or wherever he's at, and then he acknowledges that his background at the before Deadspin was. He was a part of one. He was a hacktivist working with the anonymous hacktivism movement or whatever it is they do. And so to me, it was just like, so a guy that unethically is hacking into people's lives and exposing people or whatever, that's who becomes one of the top editors at Deadspin. And we're going to cast him as some sort of great journalist. And my takeaway on that is this is what I've always suspected about Deadspin. Timothy Burke is the kind of guy, fit the profile of a lot of Deadspin employees. And it goes to that hacking, investigating people, doxing people through computers and all. And Steve, I've said this over and over. I don't know if I've ever said it to you, but I think that's one of the biggest reasons why so many ESPN, corporate media, Fox Sports people, CNN, MSNBC, why so many of them all say the same thing is because someone like Tim Burke knows everything about them. He's hacked into their lives. He's got them by the balls. I've seen so many people that I respected afraid of Deadspin hacking into their lives, finding out what their secrets are. Are they in the closet? Are they cheating on their wives? Are they banging their boss? And these guys, they're hackers, like this Timothy Burke, and they blackmail and compromise people.
Yeah.
And that whole era when they had ESPN by the balls is because many of those male ESPN executives were banging everybody they could and sexually harassing everybody they could, and I believe the guys over at Deadspin knew it, either through sources or through hacking emails and all that other stuff. And it's one of the reasons why, and among other reasons, because I just prefer to live transparently, it's one of the reasons why I've been so honest about me and my flaws and the life that I lived. I don't want to give anybody the ammo to say, hey, man, Whitlock portrays himself one this way or that way, but I knew this stripper he was living with out in Los Angeles. I already done cop to that, bro. And she liked to smoke weed, and I smoked weed with her, and blah, blah. I'm going to cop to all of it. And because I'm they get people by the balls.